Probably.
All right, here we go. Lesbian couple of 55 years. Ready to say, I do. Thank you, California. This is, we got another Gus and Elmer situation. Gus and Elmer is one of our favorite stories ever.
Oh, they ruled.
They fucking ruled.
Two just old flaming gay homos guys. And
finally you got to get married. One was what? Do we remember the ages?
They were in their
60s. Elmer. Rock.
I think they were like 80 or something.
They were
something.
In their 80s. They were as old as dirt.
The old dirt road. Yeah, Gus and Elmer. And we were just kind of wondering how it was when they were young and gay, since they, you know, grew up in a time we didn't really accept that. And
88 and 84.
And they were both they were both war veterans.
Yeah.
And we were just imagining what the newsreel footage would sound like talking. Here they are, ladies, two bachelors. They just haven't found the right girl yet, we suppose.
Look
at these two. They're the best of chums, spending all their time together. Out and about. I'm sure cruising for girls. Hubba hubba. Here they are at the Stork Club. Look at the women wandering about, looking at them. They don't even look interested, playing hard to get, Gus and Elmer.
Just
they don't want to fess up to the fact that they're gay.
Just not acknowledging that they're gay.
Two soldiers fresh back from the war zone.
Know who's the greatest at that? Regis Philbin. If you want to have fun,
oh,
when these flaming gay guys go on like Regis and Kelly for the interview... There's Gus and Elmer, by the way.
Gus and Elmer. Oh, God.
The one looks like Ernest Hemingway.
Old shriveled cocks.
And the other one looks like old character actor.
No, Maud's husband.
Yeah. Regis Philbin.
He's got a bolo tie.
Regis Philbin will get guys on that are so obvious that they're gay.
Everyone knows they're gay.
The audience does. Kelly does. Everybody. And Regis will just ask the dumb, when are you settling down question.
So, have you found a lady? Have you found yourself a lady yet? I'm certain they must be chasing you like crazy. Right, Gelman? What do you think? I don't even know Gelman's a fan. How am I supposed to know when a guest likes to suck the cock?
Speaking of which... And this is my humble opinion.
Yeah.
Who was the old guy in Regis and Kelly? He wears like salmon-colored suits and pink ties. And what's his name? The older guy. They try to set him up. They did a whole thing. It lasted for weeks where they try to set him up on a date.
Really?
Art? His name Art?
Art.
Same thing with Regis, though, like asking all sorts of questions. This guy's been with him for 40 years or whatever it's been. And they're trying to set him up on a date, and they finally did, and it was obvious, like...
So what is it about a woman that you find most attractive? A cock!
Well, with that, we got a lesbian couple of 55 years ready to say I do. You got Phyllis Lyon and Dell Martin. They fell in love at a time when lesbians risked being arrested.
Arrested?
Fired from their jobs and sent to electroshock treatment.
Nice. The good old days, we like to call that.
That's how they get your lips.
That's how they cured lesbianism?
That's how they got your lips off the pussy.
Wow.
They had to hook you up to electrodes. They
smacked your face with a trout while they did it.
I was talking to this Arab guy that used to work at the cellar, and he goes, you faggot? I go, no, I'm not. He goes, you know what we do to faggots in my country? We throw rockets at them until they feel better.
Until they feel better.
If that doesn't work, we fuck them in the ass.
He did not say
I swear
that.
To God.
There was a time where, can we look that up? Lesbians were arrested, fired from their jobs, and sent to electroshock treatment. On Monday. Whoa! Oh.
Wow. Whoa.
Sound effects.
No more carpet.
So weird.
On Monday... More than a half century after they became a couple, Ryan and Martin plan to become one of the first same-sex couples to legally exchange marriage vows in California.
California, wow.
San Francisco Mayor Gavin Newsom plans to officiate at the private ceremony in his city hall office before 50 invited guests. He picked Martin, 87, and Lyon, 84, for the front of the line in recognition of their long relationship and their status as pioneers of the gay rights movement. Mm. Oh
my God. Hair pioneers. Look at these two lookers, boys. Yes, certain to turn heads as they walk down any boulevard. These two lookers are looking for a man. Are they really? Diamonds are a girl's best friend, gentlemen. So if you're looking for these two honeys, you better have some money. Or a vagina. That's great.
They've been bumping donuts for 55 years.
Love the muff.
That's just nasty. You know you're a fucking lesbian when you still fucking like the box at 80-something.
Oh, like, really?
You know what an 80-year-old box looks like?
Do you think they're really doing it, or are they just an old couple that are in love?
What do you think, they're just kissing and hugging?
Yeah, things like that. You don't just think they... Oh, sweetie.
You're out of your mind.
Nothing like that. You think they're doing the scissor? Those lesbians, when they put their legs together and do the scissor?
I think there's some...
The two-headed dildo.
I see that in the porno movies, and they're grabbing each other's ankles and just grinding their twats together. And That's pretty hot in those movies, I gotta be honest.
Desperately trying to get something inside.
Something going. There's just nothing there.
Trying to smash their clits to swell up.
Yeah, they're just rubbing them, mashing them together.
Just trying to get a centimeter of anything inside.
Anything. Slide your clit in me.
I think this lesbian couple, they still enjoys ass eating.
Ugh.
I think they instill.
I don't think that is that a woman thing? Is that that's a guy gay thing? That's not a.
I don't know. Let's ask. Do lesbians eat each other's asses?
Do they like ass eating? Lesbians?
Why would you?
What are their names?
Why would you if you got a clean hole and a dirty hole? Why wouldn't you?
Do they? What are their names again?
Phyllis.
Phyllis.
It's definitely a lesbian name.
And Dell.
Phyllis and Dell.
D-E-L.
Eat my ass, Dell. Dell. Dell? Would you eat my ass today? Well, of course. I love eating ass. Just bends over the bed and I'll start munching that ass. Oh, Dell, that's wonderful. Let's name that haircut the mullet. It's a new invention. It's wonderful. Now take off that... sweater, that oversized sweater. I'll take off my flannel and let's bump donuts. We'll do a scissor.
Take down the Murphy bed.
Yeah, the Murphy bed. Ah, that ass licking feels wonderful. I'll tell you, sure can lick an ass. Oh, that's great.
Dave C. from Flint writes, that has to be like licking a sand trap. Wow, they were the pioneers in the gay rights. 87, let's see, we got Dell at 87 and Phyllis at 84.
Gonna need a Manhattan to straighten my breath out.
Just old pubes, just feel dead.
Feel dead.
Like the hair is just dead. There's no more life to the hair.
I put conditioner in that.
Her but the sides of her pussy must look like an armpit.
Oh, shit. Along with six other women, they founded a San Francisco social club for lesbians back in 1955.
Ah.
They called it the Daughters of Bilitis. What does that mean? B-I-L-I-T-I-S. Daughters of Bilitis. Under their leadership, it evolved into the nation's first lesbian advocacy organization. Mm. They have the FBI files to prove it. The FBI was on them. The feds were on them. Ah!
They're on you now.
The feds
tinkle,
The feds were
Yeah.
A close look at the
well, you got to watch out.
The Daughters of Bilitis.
What was their gig?
It's considered to be the first lesbian rights organization in the U.S. It was formed in San Francisco. The group was conceived as a social alternative to lesbian bars, which were considered illegal and thus subject to raids and police harassment.
Ah! Wow.
It lasted for 14 years and became a tool of education for lesbians, gay men, researchers, and mental health professionals.
As what makes a lesbian tick? Let's hook electrodes to her labia and see what makes her a lesbian.
It's very establishment in the midst of witch hunts.
Mm. Yeah.
And police harassment was an act of courage, since members always had to fear that they were under attack, not because of what they did, but merely because of who they were.
No, it's what you did. Licking a box when you own your own. That's what they did. They did.
Oh, I'm sorry. Dave from Philly writes, you're reading it wrong. It's the Daughters of Clitoris. Dickie Punchcock says they're... I don't like saying the C word. I just can't say it sometimes.
Ma pulsa.
Their twats must look like Charles Bronson sucking on a lemon.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
Should I read on? The feds.
Please.
We're after Dell and Phyllis. All they want to do is just have some women, woman love.
I mean, a lesbian bar back then being raided by
my
cops.
Like, wow.
Like it's Al Capone. Fuck, what do they do? Just run out into the street and just a bunch of...
All right, lesbians, come out with your hands up. Come out with your hands up, lesbians. We're going to smell all of your fingers. If it smells like a day at the fishing hole, you're under arrest. We don't like your kind here. They haven't come up, they won't come up with shaving for years. What a mess. They all look like German psychiatrists. Little beards.
All right, lesbians, put down those pussies. And come on out.
Yes, lesbians, drop the pussies and come out. On the floor.
Put your tongues back.
Yes, tongues in mouths. All right, this is a bust, lesbians. Get the tits out of your mouth.
Stop scissor fucking.
No, scissor fucking is illegal in 13 counties.
Drop those dildos.
Drop the dildo. Drop it, lesbian. We know what your kind likes. Okay, go around there, Murphy. Check the teeth for pubes.
Murphy, Jesus.
Well, all cops were Irish back then. They still are, for the most part.
say come out, lesbians, again, in your style. I love it.
Lesbians, come out. Come out with your fingers in the air.
Drop the box and grab your socks, Florida Steve.
We're arresting lesbians.
Everyone's giving you a little hand today. Pierce writes, freeze up, or I'll show you my cock.
Yes, you hate the cock, don't you? This is like a 1950s taser to them. They just collapse on the ground. Oh, you hate that cock. Okay, come on out, lesbians. Wrong bar. These are all men. Look at the hair and the pants they're wearing. They couldn't possibly be women.
Chester's liver. All right, lesbians, remove those fancy belts.
What is that on the front of your belt, lesbians?
Lesbians.
Why are only half of you wearing them?
You almost went into BORAT there.
Lesbian, you're under arrest.
What's up with the fancy belts?
Fancy belts? I've never seen a buckle like that before.
Oh, my God. All right. The couple who live, we're still talking about Phyllis and Dell, 87 and 84. Been a couple for 55 years. Now they're going to be married.
Looks like the same.
Here's the
gay
last.
Old guys.
Here's, look at the one on the left. Looks like she has constipation.
He sure it's not the other guys just in drag.
The couple who live in the same San Francisco Whoa. House they bought in 1956.
Oh, it's just gross.
Do not get out much now. Martin needs a wheelchair to get around.
Oh, that must be nice.
Do you still lick snatch if you're stuck in a wheelchair?
Yeah, she just like goes forward and backwards into the other one's tongue with the wheelchair.
Yeah, but you gotta have like swamp butt and all that.
Yeah.
The whole area's gotta be swampy.
Look at her lumpy arthritic knuckles.
What's going on there? Oh, yeah.
She can't even finger pop her anymore.
Her fingers are ribbed for her pleasure.
She has to just rub her knuckles backwards on her clit.
Yeah. Dave B. from Philly, can we start that music up again there?
Look at how the one with the gray hair is dressed. Just like the captain of the Titanic. She looks like... Yes.
Newsreel. The FBI raided what was thought to be a black market salmon factory.
Turned out to be a house full of lesbians. The bus went down without incident when they were shown penises and fell to the ground in tears.
Come out, lesbians.
Yes. Look at, here's the film of the bust going down. These girls don't know what cum tastes like. They'll never know the pleasure of one of our soldiers bringing them home silk stockings. 'Cause they're lesbians.
The happy couple. We get along well, Phyllis said, and we love each other. I love you too, Dell said.
Ah, that's sweet.
Why couldn't a couple of these pal talk girls get together? You're under arrest. You're under house arrest at Anthony's prison.